Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today with a quick preview of a game called Rebel Galaxy, due out to release sometime this year on PC, Xbox One, and PS4. I am playing it here on the PC, but with an Xbox 360 gamepad. Just wanted to clarify why you might be seeing those buttons up at the top right of the screen. Rebel Galaxy is a rock-infused open world, but still structured from a story perspective. Space game with some of the elements you might expect. Trading, the ability to go from different outposts and space stations, finding the best prices on different types of commodities and taking those and trying to get the best price somewhere else, perhaps. Flying at light speed to get there, which is not as fast as it might initially seem, because you get interrupted very frequently by all types of bandits and pirates and stuff who can just pull you out of warp whenever they please. That can get kind of obnoxious, but we're not going to talk about that right now. Sometimes it's in your best interest to escape. You can't win every battle, and oftentimes you're going to find yourself outnumbered and outclassed. We're starting the game off here with the default ship. It's not exactly a tiny ship. It can easily handle fighters, but there are at least two other classes of ship above that, which we'll be taking a look at later. Not only can you trade, of course you're going to be fighting, maybe hunting some bounties down, or collecting some old ancient artifacts from long-forgotten asteroid fields or whatever, and then finally, you're going to be able to mine. I've seen some mining units that you can apply to your ship, and I've also seen some mineral-written asteroids, so I'm assuming that that's possible, even though I haven't done it myself. So those are the three kind of tenets of space games, right? You gotta have combat, you gotta have trading, and you gotta have some mining, resource collection. And then it's got all three of those. Now, the problem with space games has always been spreading itself too thin in the genre. When you try to have all three of those things, is it possible to do all of those three things well, or do you end up doing them all kind of average? Now, since the game is still in development, I'm not here to review it, I'm not here to slam it one way or another, but I am, of course, I always give my thoughts both ways, what I've enjoyed and what I don't enjoy. So we're gonna have both of those. Number one, I like the way of the presentation. I like that style of music anyway. If you don't like this kind of rock, there probably is a way to turn it off, but it's only got a few tracks. So even though I like the music, I feel like given any playlist, you're eventually going, oh, it's that song again. Okay. It would be cool definitely to see a lot more options and maybe even a button to skip to the next song, which for all I know is in the options, but I haven't seen it. Beyond the music, of course, you probably want to hear how it feels to control the ships and why it looks like we're pretty much staying on a static plane. We're not doing any crazy loops or flying upside down versus the other ships. We're all kind of oriented the exact same. Everyone's right side up, as it were. And that is because you can only move forward, backwards, left, and right. You can't move in diagonals. You can't go down. You can't climb up. Everyone's stuck on the same plane. Just imagine, if you will, that I am a ship, a giant naval vessel in a wide ocean of space. And that is how we are able to move, and also how we're able to shoot. Your primary weapon in the game are broadside cannons. And with my starter ship, we only get one real option for broadsides. Future ships have more hardpoints, so you can throw on more weapons, more firepower, more heavier barrages. Right now we're aligning where we are firing our laser barrage on our broadside with left trigger, and that's creating the little line stretching out into the distance that you're seeing. And as it closes in on its sides, it becomes more accurate. So the longer you hold it down until it flashes yellow, the more accurate your shots become. If you just shoot without first aligning your shot, then it's just going to spread the three little laser beams out in any direction, really. So it's a matter of how long do you want to hold it down. Maybe if you hold it down less and don't wait for a completely accurate shot, you get to shoot faster, but it might be slightly more inaccurate. Speaking of inaccuracy, the thing that kind of bothers me the most about the combat is not being limited to this single plane. I don't mind not being able to fly up and down. That's not really what bothers me. What bothers me about the combat is that it feels a little bit hollow, because I find that my ship tends to do too much for me, and it kind of is representative of the rest of the game. There's a lot of hand-holding, it feels like, in places where I don't want any hand-holding, but then there's not enough hand-holding in other areas that are a little bit confusing for me. Specifically with combat, what I mean is, there are some instances, plenty, where you have a load of fighters on the screen, like 7, 8 fighters that are all attacking you, and you can only see where one is at a time, because of the way that it's your targeting reticule works. So if you're aiming in the direction of a fighter, it'll highlight it in red and kind of show you where it is. Obviously, your mini-map reveals where all those enemies are, but I would love, first of all, if all of your enemies, once they become known, have a little red diamond around them or whatever, just to let you know where they are at all times, because they can fly above you and underneath you, and it's easy to lose track of them because they have a little bit more 3D control as to where they're flying. But beyond that, when they're all huddled up together, it can be very difficult to pick out one to shoot. So yes, you can lock on to one target, but it's usually an extra step that maybe doesn't need to be taken. And the reason it shouldn't need to be taken is because in something like World of Warships, for example, you have a very precise control over where you are firing your cannons. So if you shoot maybe just a little bit too far ahead of the enemy ship, the enemy vessel, then your rounds will completely miss. Here, there's almost an auto-aim feature. So let me bring all this together and try to get all this various information combined into one little bundle. When you're shooting at an enemy, whatever the game thinks your target is, it'll kind of lean your lasers over towards that target, even though you may not have wanted to hit that target. You don't have finesse when you shoot. As long as there is a ship inside of that little cone, your lasers will automatically hit that ship, whether they're above you, below you, and by trying to automatically do that for you, it ends up almost frustrating. Just because, no, that's not the one I wanted to hit. I wanted to hit the other fighter who's almost dead right next to that guy. Why did you automatically target this guy over here? So I would love if I had more control over where the lasers are actually going to strike. And that's why combat ends up feeling hollow, because it's primarily a game of locking onto the target that you want, getting it even just remotely close to accurate, and then the lasers will just do the rest. You just click enough times until it dies. I don't feel like I am having any impact really on the accuracy of my shots, and thus the satisfaction is taken away. Not only because of the fact that it's automatically almost doing it for me, but also because of the limited amount of distance you're allowed to shoot. If you are outside of a very tiny radius, then your shots just disappear into space and they won't reach their targets. And oftentimes, even when I'm in range, the lasers kind of disappear off of my screen. The draw distance cuts it off too short, and I can't tell if my lasers hit or not, even if it's still within range and feasibly should hit the target. So I know that was a long-winded explanation, but combat is probably the central figure of this game. Yes, you can trade. Obviously, if you want to play it another way and just do primarily trading, that's perfectly acceptable. It seems like there's a good commodity system in place to help you do that. Some of the stations can have things like famine, where they desperately need food, and you can go find another system that has a plentiful amount of food, buy it at a cheap price, go sell it to the people who are in famine. Sometimes they'll have overstocks in technology, so they've been just producing too many high-tech goods, and so they'll have them at a nice, cheap surplus sale for you. You can go buy those and take them to somewhere where they're more needed. You get the idea. Trading is very viable, from what I can tell, but primarily you're going to be taking on bounties and things from the mission board that will try to get you to go out and fight people, blow them up, and so on and so forth. So I like the combat well enough once you get enough weapons. On my starter ship, I can have two kind of broadside weapons, one primary, which is the lasers, and the second one I can have an ordnance, so I have some dumbfire missiles that are really, really satisfying when they actually strike. But again, with the combat, it's hard to be accurate with them. So when I'm firing these dumbfire missiles, I can't see a good trajectory as to where they're actually going to fire from. They seem to go out perpendicular to my ship, but it makes it very difficult to aim because there's not even a guideline that shows me where they're going to shoot out, so I tend to just kind of guess. And I wish they could kind of take the guesswork out of it. If they can make combat fully within my control, and sometimes they do. For example, the two baby turrets that I have on my ship that comprise the other half of my ship's armaments, you can actually take control of. They're primarily useful for being anti-fighter, so they'll kind of do their own thing when you don't have manual control over them. I happen to have one flat cannon that automatically will shoot nearby fighters, and I also have a little mini missile launcher that'll auto-target them. Those both work wondrously. I can even go in and manually control those to fire them myself if I want to. And it seems like I have more accuracy doing that than I do with the broadside cannon. So I would like to see user control given a little bit more. I want the full control, is what I'm trying to say. When I'm teased with these space games, I want to be the spaceship commander. I want to be able to push the button to start charging my warp drive before it gets damaged by the enemy, and then at the last second push the button to get away. Like, that's not really a feasible possibility, just because you've got to have clear, free, visible room and hope that you don't get too close to maybe an asteroid field, because it'll automatically pull you out of warp if you get too close to anything. I just want more control, I guess, is the bottom line here. I have enjoyed what I've played, I will tell you that. The upgrading grind is actually pretty addicting. There's a number of upgrades you can buy per individual ship from each of the stations, and many of the stations will have a different variety of upgrades for you. So not only can you upgrade your weapons, which is pretty obvious since we've been talking about that already, you can also upgrade things like your shield. You can buy a deflector shield that you can toggle manually, so if you see a missile barrage coming in, you can manually toggle on a deflector shield to try to negate that damage. There's also some hull upgrades. You can upgrade your engines, your boosters. You can even upgrade your faster-than-light drive, assuming that's what it's called. I assume that's what it is. So even though I might complain about it taking minutes to get from point A to point B while you're warping, there are ways to upgrade your warp drive. It's just going to cost you a little bit of credits in-game. So I like that they thought about those things to make them easier, more quality of life upgrades for you to work towards. And as I said, there's also a few different classes of ships. I have not gotten to try out any of the bigger classes, but they do sound pretty fun just because some of them have so many different hardpoints. Like, one of them has 4 or 6 different broadside points and a number of the smaller turrets for anti-fighter measures. I love the idea of that upgrade tree. I love being able to progress from this tiny little starter ship to those bigger capital ships and frigates. Sounds like a lot of fun. So the carrot on the stick is there. I like that about the game, and it feels very open-ended too. There's going to be a number of solar systems. I only have access to one at the moment, so I don't know how to port between the different systems. And I understand that a lot of the bigger ships are going to have the ability to instantly teleport through gateways or portals from one place to the next. It all sounds really cool, and it feels like there is a live ecosystem here. I find traders coming in, and there's pirates kind of waiting just outside of the different stations to interrupt them, and sometimes there's distress beacons that'll call for help. So I like the world that they've created, and it feels like it's fairly priced at around $20, I think they said, when it does eventually come out. So all of that's good. All those decisions are great. But in the moment-to-moment gameplay, and primarily the combat, it feels more as if my hand is being held just a little bit more than I would like. I would love to have World of Warships style control over my broadside cannons, and be able to shoot some long distance space battles would be cool, some optics maybe to zoom in and see where those rounds are hitting. That would be really awesome, but right now it kind of boils down to get really close to enemy ship, drive alongside it, alternatively drive in a circle counter to that ship, and you keep shooting until one or the other dies. So there definitely needs to be another layer of strategy there. The reason why they probably can't do what I'm suggesting, I think the auto-aim is there primarily because our ship, the player ship, is stuck in the ocean of the sea, right? We're going forward, backwards, left, and right only. But the fighters and some of the other smaller gunships are able to fly all the way up and around us. So they can't give that level of control, because otherwise, however would we hit the different ships that are flying above us and below us. That's why it auto-aims a bit, so it can shoot the lasers automatically down or up as necessary. So I understand why it's there. I would just prefer it if every single ship in the galaxy was stuck on that same level. Anyways, guys, I encourage you to keep an eye on Rebel Galaxy in the future. It has not come out yet. There is no date just yet. But like I said, $20 does seem like a fair price for what I've been playing so far here, even despite the fact that most of the quests so far are MMO level quality. Fetch quests or kill X number of enemy quests. They may not have the number there, but that's kind of what it boils down to. I'm willing to overlook though all that because I like the carrot on the stick gameplay. I like upgrading to higher tiers and qualities of ships and weapons and armors and parts. So I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. I'm not complaining about the nature of the quests at all. I just want the combat to feel a little bit better. That's the bottom line. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. It ended up going a little bit longer than I thought. It's hard to explain exactly how the mechanics of this work, so I hope I did an okay job letting you know how it looks and giving you enough gameplay here so you can make your own informed decision, which is what I encourage you to do. Just because some of these pieces may not be for me doesn't mean they can't be for you also, but I hope you give it a chance if you're thinking about it. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I hope to see you again soon.